class went on a bus, a trip, and we stopped for food on the way back, and we both decided to go to Panda Express at the stop, and he was sitting by himself. And I sat down and asked if anyone was sitting there, and he said no, and we talked for like a half hour. And then we kind of knew each other from classes on and off. We had clinicals on and off after that. And then we started studying and kept talking and kept talking for Christmas break. And then one thing led to another, and here we are today.
Exactly. Okay, so for the proposal, I'm playing this out ahead of time. I wanted to take her to a place in Holland, Michigan, called Mount Pisgah. And it's basically a place on the beach that, like, it's several flights of stairs. I think there's like 300 total stairs. And at the very top, it's very scenic and beautiful, and it's awesome. So I brought her up several flights of stairs, and she was gasping, really tired. And so was I, because I was out of shape, and still am. So I brought her to the top. We had a couple of rest periods, and I eventually got up on her knee and said some words.
So, yeah. Probably just that he balances me out. He's very quiet, but also very deep thinker. He has a lot going on in his head all the time, and just like he can ground me and balance out my crazy. And he's very rational, where I'm very emotional. So it's just good balance. We work out the best parts of each other.
I would say how caring she is for other people. She is a giver. Through in and out. She rarely asks for anything. And that is something I find pretty unique, because not very many people are generous and are willing to put themselves last.
You're not eating lunch alone like a weird kid. Come on. So he drove.
I've been spending way too long checking my tongue in the mirror.
Thank you.
backwards just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better.
Eric was sitting by himself, and then Sarah came over and sat and talked for like a minute.
Yeah, that's true. And then they were study buddies.
Remember that time you downloaded Facebook Snapchat to talk to Sarah?
Aww. First time I met her. She walked in our house and they just turned around.
She was like shy but like confident, and she reminded me so much of like myself, and I was just so excited that she was gonna, like, I just knew. Like, she was gonna be part of our family. And it's really a funny story. I love the way he can tease her and she like reacts to it.
She's like really nice and he just fits right in with her family.
I think they're both pretty unique. in a good way. Doesn't matter if you're right, she's right.
You're gonna have good days, you're gonna have bad days, you start to look at it.
My advice is to ignore the other party as much as possible. Just tune them out, because eventually it'll drive you insane.
It's a celebration.
I think everybody kind of wants to have a legacy that they leave behind and makes this world a better place. And I don't often feel like that. But when I look at you kids, as I grew up in this world, we as a team, I'm not just proud of it.